I thank Art of Living and Rajesh ji and CCI for this wonderful conference here. It's a rare opportunity to talk to so many people who are interested in eradicating cancer, diagnosing it early, and devising ways of helping, you know, the underprivileged and the needy ones. So I am a medical oncologist, and I treat cancer patients with chemotherapy. And in this long journey, I have, you know, being an allopathic practitioner, and Nagendra ji spoke a lot about yoga and meditation and other practices. So, you know, my talk would be an extension of what he said, and I can vouch that as an allopathic practitioner, this is possible. And I am working on integrative medicine a lot, so this is my passion and interest to do all this work. And so first of all, namaste. Namaste is an ancient Indian tradition of greeting. And just to spend a few seconds on the meaning of namaste. It's a very deep meaning, which says, I honor the place in you in which the entire universe dwells, and I honor the place in you which is of love, truth, light, peace. And when you are in that place in you, and I am in that place in me, we are one. So we recognize the divinity in the other person. Now coming to health, how do we define health? Yes? All of you know it? No disease, absence of disease, and we are at ease. Yes? Little more? Happy? Happy state of mind, yes. So health is physical, mental, social, and spiritual well-being, right? So we can define in a simple way like this. And so for a, you know, again, a healthy life, what more do we require? What else? Physically health, physically, mentally, good doctors, okay, yes. Happiness, discipline, what else? Exercise, some peace, contentment, huh? Positive thinking, yes. And? Good genes, okay. Yes. So if you don't have good genes, you are sort of not going to be happy. Is that a reasonable belief system? So we need, you know, so truthfulness, balance, happiness, joy, bliss, a life purpose, freedom, free will, self-realization, being close to reality, sincerity, awareness, to live in awareness, creativity, right? Contentment, success. So all these are ingredients of a happy, healthy, successful life. So now my question to the audience is, as doctors, so mainly doctors here, so when we are dealing with patients, are we treating them or are we healing them? So we are medically treating them most of the times, isn't it? So we are treating most of the times, but not going to the healing part of it. So we can define, you know, we can debate on that, what is difference between treating and what is healing, but you know it internally. As we say these words, treatment and healing are a little different. So we know this concept of body, mind, and soul, right? All of us are, you know, routinely this has become a fad, a fashion to, you know, say body, mind, and soul. So body we all know, right? Physical body. We can see, we can touch, we can hear, physical body. But what about your mind? Where is the mind? Yes, Grey's Anatomy, did it define? Where is the mind? Where is our mind? It permeates the thoughts. It is in the thoughts. So mind is, you know, so it's like a ball of light. It encases, it surrounds and permeates all the cells, the whole being. And mind has conscious and subconscious part. This we all know, right? It's very important to understand the power of this, right? So conscious mind is the logical mind, and the subconscious mind is the storehouse of all the information. Your childhood, your previous lives, if you believe in reincarnation or not. And so subconscious mind is very powerful. It's like the RAM and the hard disk of your mobile. Like we have 4 GB, 6 GB RAM mobile phones, but we have 64 GB, 128 GB hard disk, where we can store all your, you know, files, pictures, videos, and you can take it out whenever required, right? So subconscious mind is the storehouse of all your information. But why is it important? As doctors, why, and as health workers, why do we need to understand this concept of subconscious mind? Because this is a very powerful tool. If you work with subconscious mind, you can do wonders in, you know, changing your belief systems and doing affirmations. Can I have a volunteer here, please? Yes? No? This is not going to be a fun experiment. Dr. Lalit? Yeah, you can come next. Please come. So we'll demonstrate the power of your subconscious mind here. आप अपना हाथ ऐसे करें आगे. मैं बहुत फोर्स से नीचे करूंगा. आपको बोलना है मेरा नाम ललित है और मुझे करने नहीं देना है, राइट?
बोलो. मेरा नाम ललित है, मेरा नाम ललित है, मेरा नाम ललित है.
मैंने फोर्स लगाया अच्छे से. अब बोलो मेरा नाम सचिन है.
मेरा नाम सचिन है.
ओके.
मेरा नाम सचिन है.
अब फिर बोलो ललित.
मेरा नाम ललित है.
इज देयर अ डिफरेंस? Devshish ji, you can please come. Thank you. So this is not a fluke. I'll tell you what is happening here. आपको भी पहले अपना नाम बोलें. जोर लगाएं पूरा. हाँ.
मेरा नाम देवाशीष है. मेरा नाम देवाशीष है.
हाँ. आप बोलो मेरा नाम सचिन है.
मेरा नाम सचिन.
फिर से बोलो.
मेरा नाम सचिन.
Are you convinced? Thank you so much. So what happened? Inka brain, you know, this is intact. Nerves, muscles, sab signal ja raha hai na wahan pe muscles mein. But inka jo, you know, what is happening? His subconscious mind has a belief that he is Lalit, he is Devashish, right? That belief is there for your 40, 50, whatever your age is, right? That belief is there that he is Lalit. But now suddenly, you knock off that belief. That you are not Lalit, you are Sachin. No, it is not acceptable. It is not acceptable to your subconscious, which is the storehouse of power, right? So when you change that, the subconscious mind is not helping you with the power, right? So in spite of your brain, your muscles, nerves, sab kuch intact hai, but power is not there because the belief system has been challenged. So this tells you how powerful your mind is, the subconscious mind is. So the beyond mind, we have a soul, right? How many of you believe in the soul? So most of us, right? So we are not going to debate here whether soul is, this is not the purview of this conference, that would become very difficult. So as spiritual beings, we have a soul, we have a mind, we have a body. Now coming to the belief system, right? So now we know the power of the subconscious mind, isn't it? We know it, we have just demonstrated. So we all have belief systems, right? Like if we have curd in dinner, we'll have cough. Or potatoes give me gas, or you know, eating this gives me this. Or beliefs like ghar se nikal ke kali billi rasta kaat jaye to kuch nuksan ho jayega na. This is also a belief. Koi chheenk maar de to, you know, ruk jao. You know, our dadi used to tell us ki you stop and 5 minutes wait karo, fir jao ghar se bahar. So we all have beliefs, right? And beliefs operate us. These beliefs have a strong influence on our mind, on our psychology, and our physical health also. Now suppose you go to your doctor and the doctor tells, and you have diabetes, you are diagnosed with diabetes, and the doctor tells ki diabetes to kabhi, it's an incurable thing, isn't it? This is what medical practitioners believe. So can it be cured if we go with this belief?
Yes.
if we nahin, you have cured it, but if you have a belief it cannot be cured, then you won't be able to do it. Similarly, if you have a belief hypertension cannot be cured, cancer cannot be cured, we can't do anything about it, isn't it? So this is how belief system works. And why is it important? Of course, we have, you know, advanced stage cancer patients, stage 4, where, you know, medically we know they can't be cured, yes? So we do get terminal cancer patients, I'm not denying that. But we also have patients who have done wonderfully well, in spite of us telling them that you're going to live for 3 months, 4 months, 6 months, they have lived for many, many years. There are so many examples. Dr. Malhotra, sir, you would agree to that? There are some patients who defy all these logics and, you know, medical statistics. And we are not able to explain them, so we say these are anecdotal cases, this is by chance, this is autoregression, this is autoimmunity may have worked, you know. But we have these patients, right? And the medical science is not able to explain them. So why not give hope rather than prognosticating too badly about it, isn't it?
Sachin, we are short of time.
Yeah, so I can sum up. So I have said, you know, my two important things was power of subconscious mind and the belief system. And so I'll sum up, how do we change the belief system, right? So we have, now we know this is very powerful. We can change belief systems by using the power of affirmations, right? So affirmations are some magical words which, you know, we can use. And these, you know, the sound waves, the positive thoughts, they have direct effect on our DNA also. Genes also, you can change your genes. You are not prisoners of your genes. You are the masters of your genes. This is what we need to understand. There's a cell biologist by name Bruce Lipton. Somebody has read Biology of Belief. It is wonderfully explained that genes are just protein factories. Your thoughts, you will govern what happens, what kind of proteins they make. Right? So please, look at your thoughts, what you are thinking about, what you are saying. Positive thoughts, positive words will bring positive action on the body. So to our patients, we can always tell that, okay, this is an advanced disease, but I have seen many patients who have lived for many years in spite of this. So we can, you know, even the grave prognosis can be layered with positive words. That is possible. It is just how we project it. And of course, to the family, you can tell that, you know, the medical literature says that such patients live for so many, so and so, you know, the prognosis is like that. But covering with good, kind words can be very helpful for the patients. Any ray of hope can help them live longer, live healthier, live with peace and comfort. So we may not be able to cure, but at least we can comfort most of the times, all the time. You know, that comfort we can always give. Is that so or not? Thank you so much.